can just find it, then it leaves.
You look lost.
What's lost is my body. I know I got killed right here. And I know it sounds crazy, but I'd feel a lot better if I knew where my body was. Are you a detective or something? You might be my only hope.
Yeah, I'm a detective. Any idea who did it? That might lead us to your body.
I know they were old people. And I know they lived in this apartment building. Other than that, everything is hazy. But I was doing a lot of drugs at the time.
Sounds like you do need a detective. I'll see what I can find out from any older residents of the building.
Honey, they can probably hear you talking through the ceiling.
Well, they do. Every time we visit Jennifer at this place, it's the same weird characters. That other lady on the second floor, she changes boyfriends like she changes sweaters. And my goodness, the racket.
I know that upsets you, dear.
Like paper when Grace hit her. I still can't believe she died. It happened so fast. I've never seen Grace so crazy before. It must have been the lack of sleep. Thank God it's all over. I can finally watch TV in peace.
Sleep through music blasting like that. I think she was on drugs. Walter was so tired, he could barely stay awake for the 5 miles it took to drive to Smithwick Quarry. I couldn't believe he was able to find a pair of lock cutters that late at night. At least the music has stopped. Now we can finally sleep.
Mysterious.
Looks like Grace couldn't take the girls partying anymore, so she killed her and dropped her husband into helping dump the body at Smithwick Quarry. I should get back and let her know.
Are these disappearances and murders connected? Is Salem dealing with a serial killer?
Turns out, the reason you can't find your body is because it's not in the building. It's at Smithwick Quarry, about 5 miles out of town.
Oh. Well, why'd they do it?
The parties were keeping them awake at night. They finally got too tired and snapped.
I thought they were just being unreasonable. I didn't know they would do this. Thanks for your help. You have no idea how big a relief it is just knowing.
No problem.
You know, I never really liked cops. And they were always giving me shit, telling me how I was messing up my life. We never saw eye to eye on things. But you really came through for me. Probably should have listened to what they were trying to tell me. Maybe then things wouldn't have ended up like this. Thanks again.
How the hell did it come back? Did I do that? Hey, come back!
Those notes aren't for you.
Great. Looks like some sort of code or something. All right, well, I made it up to the fourth floor before the police cart away the evidence.
Place your bets and hope you're lucky.
Thank you. Okay, folks. I need you to keep your distance from the scene here.
What happened up here?
I'm afraid that's still under investigation.
Guy got thrown out a window.
Hey, Broyles. You seen that little girl that lives here? If she turns up, you come find me. Got it?
Some killers.
They haven't caught the guy yet.
So which was it? Electrocution or slit wrists?
The razor. It was only supposed to be the razor. That's what the voices told me. The music was just something to focus on until I bled out.
So the radio was just an accident?
I started the cut. The warm water made my skin so soft, but I couldn't go through with it. The radio slipped off the edge when I was getting out. And I didn't want to die. It was the voices in my head that wanted me dead.
I'm sorry, kid.
Even push her away, if it meant pushing her to safety.
Thank you.
Turn around. You're under arrest. Was he after the girl? Where'd she go?
Anywhere that I could stay, just for a little while.
Of course, dear. The church is always here to help.
Me down in the street and you didn't even check for witnesses? Like you're untouchable. That girl is my only lead. I need to find her. Still hate heights.